Corticosteroids, more generally known simply as steroids, have been given to millions of patients since the 1940s. Modern medical best practices support using steroids as an anti-inflammatory medication to treat flare-ups of conditions like asthma and some types of arthritis. It's important to understand that despite their common use, steroids can cause serious risks. Two of the most common ways that steroids can be taken have the potential to produce very negative side effects. One way is through pills taken orally. The second way is with a needle injection. Many people don't realize that steroid injections may potentially leave behind permanent disfiguring features known as dimpling or fat atrophy at the injection site, usually given on the buttocks. This unsightly condition is irreversible. Another side effect from steroid use is an increase in blood sugar, which may pose serious problems, particularly to patients who already have diabetes. After taking steroids, patients may even experience increased anxiety, jitters, and sleepless nights for as long as 2 weeks. And for the next 1 to 2 months, the chances of bone fractures, blood clots, weight gain, joint necrosis, and infections are dramatically increased. The irony is that patients often take steroids to combat infection, yet the steroid itself actually weakens the immune system. This contradiction highlights an important fact about steroids. Despite their widespread use to treat a variety of symptoms and illnesses, the prescription of steroids is frequently not supported by scientific studies and not recommended by current best practices. Although commonly believed, steroids will not shorten the time it takes to feel better from sinus infections, allergies, bronchitis, colds, or the flu. Other types of treatments are more effective in alleviating symptoms from these conditions with fewer possible side effects. In a particularly tragic case of complications from steroids, a woman ended her own life in 2003 after being prescribed a high-dose steroid treatment to combat back pain. It's since been found that such high doses induce psychiatric symptoms, including depression, panic, and suicidal behavior in 1 out of 5 patients. Most concerning is that suicidal behavior is 6 times more frequent in those patients who have taken steroids compared to similar patients who have not. For both patients and medical providers, it's important to seriously consider whether the risks involved with taking steroids are really worth it. Is the patient suffering from a condition that legitimately calls for steroid use? Does research-based best practices recommend using steroids to treat the illness or condition? Are there less risky alternatives to steroids? Might over-the-counter drugs like Tylenol or ibuprofen be effective? At first glance, it may seem like steroids could be a quick fix for someone's discomfort. However, it's important to remember that steroids may actually do more harm than good. Steroids simply may not be the answer. Ochsner Health System is committed to protecting our patients by prescribing steroids when it makes sense to do so. Patient health is our priority, and steroids should only be used when the benefits outweigh the risks. For more information about the benefits and risks of steroids, visit ochsner.org/steroids.